Yes, he knows stock picks like I know cake mix. I eat it right out of the box. Bonson Group founder and the author of the book, There's No Free Lunch, David Bonson. Welcome to the show. You know what I noticed? These cities didn't seem to care until the smash and grab started hitting high-end luxury goods places. It's almost like they could endure the murder, but they couldn't endure the wealthy not being able to shop.
No, I think you're right. She's a funny lady, by the way, not just on this whole issue. The mayor of San Francisco is the one who was caught dancing at a wedding without a mask on.
Right.
And she said, everyone needs to be masked up. And I did take my mask off, but I won't apologize because sometimes you just got to dance.
Yes.
And then the spirit moved in her. And I think that her attitude towards this crime thing is sometimes criminals are just going to be criminals. Speaker Pelosi had said that. But it's very arbitrary. And I think that you're right. It got into higher end neighborhoods. Mm-hmm. And then Brian's point is good. I mean, a year away from the election, they know this point. It looked pretty good about a year and a half ago, celebrating barbarism, running as the party of the French Revolution. Mm-hmm. It doesn't look so good now.
Yes. And by the way, it was the Democrats, I remember, who polarized first. And then you get into a polarizing debate over who polarized first.
Yep.
The thing that kills me, David, is that the media talks about this and they somehow absolve themselves of their profit model. Yeah. Their profit model is about polarization. CNN wants to pit us versus them because then they can't make that's how they make their money. And then they fret about it.
I think you're exactly right. I think that the polarization is not perceived to be as bad by people who are not on Twitter and who don't watch CNN.
That's true.
So Twitter reality is different than most people's reality. It's a shame we don't have a precedent in our country for whether or not polarization could reach a tipping point and we actually went to war with each other or something like that. Yes. And the idea that this is the worst we've ever seen is just historically ridiculous.
Mm-hmm.
But it is unfortunate that after COVID, we divided further, whereas with 9/11, we really did unite. But, you know, the last segment is what I think the example of certain issues are that bring us back together. It's crime. It's trash in the street or feces. But I don't talk the way you people talk. but also, I think that you have seen in certain blue cities over the years, certain issues that become totally nonpartisan. They bring people back together. And the attack on entrepreneurs, business, that is another issue that I think moderates just aren't going to put up with. It brings us together in the end.
David, save me.
I think we're missing a really good side of this story, which goes back to our last segment.
Yes.
Bringing the country together.
Yeah.
Come out with a non-binary James Bond and see how quickly this country unites.
There you go.
Around the absurdity of this idea.
No, you know what, though? It could bring Caitlyn Jenner.
No.
Caitlyn Jenner, Tim, the new Bond, right?
Caitlyn Jenner's not non-binary.
Double negative.
That's true.
Thanks for playing.
But Caitlyn Jenner is from the same era as Sylvester Stallone.
Thank you.
This is still late 70s.
Yeah, very good point.
David, what's the real story here?
Well, you know, it's a shame that in a football season that goes 16 weeks, that the vacation would be in the middle of the football season when you're a football commentator.
Yes.
As if there aren't 36 other weeks where there isn't football going on that you might be able to take your vacation. You know, I can't get straight, Greg, what we're supposed to hate these rich white owners for.
Right.
Because I thought they're greedy capitalists that would do anything for a buck. Mm-hmm. But then they don't sign Colin Kaepernick. And I'm pretty sure that if he was going to bring them to a Super Bowl, he'd make them a buck.
Right.
So there's some division here. What's going on? She's 100% right, what she said, obviously. It was, and you would think they'd take her side.
Right.
Because what she's saying is that he is offensive to people who actually care about racial injustice.
Mm-hmm.
By comparing, he got $20 million for Nikes, comparing his life to that of a slave. Mm-hmm. It's completely offensive.
Yeah, slaves didn't get millions of dollars, kill me, but we won't get into that. David, what are your thoughts as you buy this? Why am I sitting like this?
I think you look comfortable. I think it's like any profession. There's some that are really smart, some that are a little less smart. But I will tell you this. I don't know how many of you ever talked to brain surgeons. I would not recommend telling them that they are not as smart as they believe they are. They are not under the impression that this story is correct.